Multibeam eco sounders use a beamforming technique to create a narrower beams from a single transmitted pulse. Here is how it works. The transducer array emits a broad fan-shaped pulse that covers a wide swath perpendicular to the vessel track. This pulse is typically a single broadband signal rather than multiple separate beams. Remember that. A single broadband signal rather than multiple separate beams. The returning echoes are received by an array of hydrophones. Using digital signal processing, the system divides the received signal into multiple narrow beams, that is 256 or 512 beams. Each beam is assigned a specific angle, allowing precise depth measurement across the swath. Each beam has an individual direction spaced at 1 degree or half a degree intervals along track and across track. So what do we understand? Multibeam does not transmit multiple beams. It transmits one long swath of fan-shaped single pulse into the seabed. While the returning echoes are processed, the signal processed into a narrower beam at the receiver end. So single beam only registers one depth value without pinpointing exactly where the footprint that reflection originated. The strongest return, one ping from the entire footprint, is recorded as depth. Since the beam covers a wide area, the exact location of the measured depth within the footprint is uncertain. If the strongest return from the edge of the footprint instead of the nadi directly below, the depth reading could be slightly misleading. On the other hand, multibeam computes depth at multiple angles, allowing precise mapping crucial for hydrographic surveys, pipeline inspection, and object detection. In multibeam, each beam has a known fixed angle. So when reflections return, the system precisely calculates depth for each beam within the swath. Because of this, every detected depth can be accurately geo-referenced. Do you know that you can join my channel as a member and have exclusive access to the videos like pipelay, jacket installation, LBL, and much, much more? Click on the join button and explore. If you do not want to be a member, then you can send me your appreciation by sending me a super thanks or buying me a coffee. Okay, so next, what is beam steering? You may have heard about beam steering, right? So the beam steering is a technique of changing the direction of the transmitted or received beam without changing the direction of the transducer. So this is achieved using a phased array technique, where multiple transducer elements work together to shape and direct the beams. Here how it works. First is phase shifting. Each transducer element emits sound waves with a slightly different phase or timing. By adjusting these phases, the wavefront can be tilted in a desired direction. This allows for the beam to be electronically steered without moving the transducer. Next is time delays. Instead of phase shifts, some systems use precise time delays in signal transmission. This creates constructive interference in a specific direction, steering the beam. And third is amplitude weighing. Adjusting the amplitude of signals across the array can shape the beam pattern. This helps reduce unwanted side lobes and improves directional accuracy. So the question is, how much can the beam angle be steered? The maximum steering angle depends on the transducer and the frequency. In simple terms, the multibeam can adjust its beam to scan the area either 60 degree to the port or 60 degree to the starboard from the vessel center line. High frequency transducers can have a very narrower beam but a limited steering angle, whereas the lower frequency echo sounders will have a higher angle of steering. It can steer up to 60 degree to either side. Now let's discuss about how many data points are recorded for each multibeam ping. Suppose a multibeam has a 512 pings, how many data points of the depths can be recorded? So multibeam, they record one depth per beams. Each 512 beams typically records one depth point, meaning 512 depth points per ping. Now there is also something called a dual Swath mode. Some advanced multibeam system use dual Swath technology, effectively doubling the number of depth points per ping. In this case, a 512 beam system could record up to 1024 depth points per ping. Now during post-processing and filtering, raw data undergoes quality control where erroneous points are removed. The final data set may contain slightly fewer depth points after filtering. So how big or how wide a seabed area a multibeam Swath can cover in just one ping? This is very important to understand the Swath angle of your multibeam system to plan your survey lines properly. The Swath angle of a multibeam system typically ranges between 90 and 150 degrees depending on the system and the frequency that you are using. Shallow water multibeam or high frequency, that is 300 to 600 kilohertz, often have 120 to 150 degrees Swath angles. Deep water multibeams, low frequency, that is 12 to 200 kilohertz, generally have 90 to 120 degrees Swath angle. So the question is, how many times of depth can the Swath be? The Swath width usually is 3 to 7 times the depth, depending on the multibeam system and environmental condition. High frequency multibeams typically achieve 3 to 4 times of the depth, and low frequency multibeams can reach 5 to 7 times of the depth. The Swath width can be estimated using this following formula: 2 multiplied by depth multiplied by tan of Swath angle divided by 2. So for a 120 degree Swath angle at 100 meter depth, the multibeam sonar would cover approximately 346 meter across the seabed. Now if you are really attentive to this video, you will notice that I have taken tan 60 degree, whereas the Swath angle of the multibeam system is 120 degree. So why did I divide the Swath angle with 2? It's the same case we did in the single beam, remember? And the reason is, we divide the entire Swath angle by 2 because half of the Swath to the port side and half of the Swath to the starboard side. And we have to work with the radius of the total transmitted beam. So using trigonometry, we can see tan theta by 2 is equal to opposite by adjacent. And here opposite is equal to depth multiplied by tan theta by 2. Since the beam spreads in both directions, we have to multiply it by 2. So Swath width is going to be 2 multiplied by depth multiplied by tan of Swath angle divided by 2. Now do you know that almost all the sonar equipment works on the same basic principle? If you are interested, here is a video how do geophysical survey equipment works. Everything explained in less than 5 minutes. So do not hesitate to ask questions and always be curious. I'll see you around.